Well, welcome back to Redeemed by Grace Fellowship, kids. I hope you've had a good week, and I hope you're ready for a good lesson today, because we got a good one coming. A lot of good information in there, but we're going to have some fun, too. Some real good fun, because I need your help again. I need your help on this one, too. And I'll tell you how we're going to how you can help me after a bit, but first, I need to remind you to make sure that you ask mom and dad if it's okay if you subscribe to this channel, whether you're watching these videos on YouTube or on Rumble. Make sure that you ask mom and dad if it's okay that you subscribe to the channel so that you always get one of these lessons, that you never miss out on. And make sure that you do ask him if he could hit that share button, too, so that we can share this video out with all your friends, with all the other boys and girls, so they get a chance to hear about Jesus and what God is doing for us and have a little fun with us, too. In fact, you might even invite him over to your house. You know, have a little popcorn, have a little drink, a little juice there. Have a good old party and watch the video together. That would be fun, wouldn't it? So make sure that you do those things. But before we get started, because we got a great, great lesson today, we are going to be talking about baby Moses by the river. The story of baby Moses. And it's going to be a fun one. So be ready for that. But just like always, before we begin in our lesson, before we begin, we need to watch our video together. So we've got a good video today. Have you ever had a bad day? I mean, a real bad day, a no good, rotten day. Well, that's what this video is all about. Let's watch. Here we go.
Ella was having a bad day. In fact, it was a no good, awful day. And then along came Mia to brighten her day.
Hi, Ella. What's up?
Ella did not want to talk because she was having such a no good, awful day. But Mia wasn't giving up. She asked,
Hey, Ella, do you want to talk about it?
Oh, you don't want to hear about it. Nobody cares and wants to hear about my day.
Give me a chance, Ella. Tell me what's up.
No one cares about me. It's like I'm invisible. I don't matter. No one cares.
I'm sorry to hear that, Ella. What makes you say that?
Well, I woke up this morning and my mom was too busy with my little brothers to help me figure out what to wear to school. I got to school and no one said hi to me in the hall. I even had to eat lunch alone. And I was so stressed, I couldn't even decide what I wanted for lunch. Then, after school, at soccer practice, no one wanted me on their team. It's like no one cares about me at all.
That is a no good, super bad day for sure, Ella. I am so sorry. But can I try to show you that someone cares about you?
Ha! Like that'll happen. But go ahead, give it your best shot.
Well, first let me say that I don't normally walk home this way. But this morning I prayed that God would use me to show his love for others. And when I was walking home, I had a strong sense to walk this way instead of the other way. I never walk this way. And who did I run into? You!
Oh, I doubt that God really had time to direct you to walk to me. I really doubt that God thinks of me at all.
See these flowers? The Bible says that God created these flowers and paid attention to every detail of how they look.
Those are just flowers.
And the Bible says, if God pays that much attention to a flower, just think about how much attention he pays to you. He cared enough to send me this way to talk to you.
Wow, God does care. I'm glad he sent you my way today. Here, you take one of these, because God cares about you too.
Thanks, Ella. Want to go get some ice cream at my house now?
Isn't it? That's pretty cool. Well, what are all these things on my screen? Wow. Let's see. What do we got here? There looks to be some baby bottles, some baby rattles. There's a baby blanket. Looks like the baby's in his blanket. We've got a baby and a sleeping tight, as well as in a sleeping chair. Looks like he's pretty tired too, doesn't he? He's yawning pretty good. And here's a baby down at the bottom. We got a pacifier. You ever had a pacifier? I remember having one. I mean, it was a long time ago, but I remember having a passy. But yeah, here we go. All those things are pretty important. Well, that kind of reminds me of the assignment that I need your help with today. You see, we're going to talk about baby Moses and how special baby Moses is, because just like our video talked about, God loves us a lot, and he loved the baby Moses too and protected him from harm. But at the same time, God loved the nation of Israel, the whole nation, because later, as we'll see in our lesson next week, when that baby grows up to be a man, God's going to send him back to Egypt, and he is going to deliver these Hebrews. He's a Hebrew himself, but he's going to help deliver that whole nation who are now under slavery. They've been there for 400 years. Yeah, and it's not pretty. And God will send Moses to go get them and to bring them out of that bad area and bring them to a beautiful promised land he has for them. But we'll learn all about that next week. So let's learn about the baby Moses today. So here's what I need you to do. Since we're talking about babies a lot today, I'm going to have to say the word baby a lot. So what I want you to do is every time, and be listening, listen close for me to say it, but every time you hear me say the word baby, I want you to make the funniest baby face you could ever make. The funniest baby face you can make. Want to practice? Get ready. 1, 2, 3. Baby! Yeah, make a good face. That's a good thing. Yeah. We'll see who makes the funniest face. Maybe I'll show you a couple pictures of funny faces too, of babies. And we'll see if yours is better or whether the one on the picture I show you is better. But we'll look at it and have some fun with it as we go through. But remember, every time I say baby, and make sure you're listening for that word, baby. But every time you hear it, make sure that you make a funny baby face. The funniest one you know how to make. And it'll be fun as we do that. But, you know, good parents, they'll do everything to keep their baby safe. Did you hear it? Did you hear it? Did you make a face? Is it better than this one? That's a pretty good one, isn't it? But, yeah, they do anything to keep their child safe. But our Bible lesson today is about a little baby boy. Did you get one? Was this one better? That one's kind of silly, isn't it? But our lesson today is about a little guy who was born in a very, very dangerous time. You see, there was a new king in Egypt. He's called the Pharaoh. And he saw that the Israelites were very, very strong. And they were growing in number. Their nation was getting larger and larger all the time because God was blessing them with new children. And they were just getting larger and larger. But that king, he was so afraid of Israelites. and he was afraid that they were going to take over his country, kick him out as king, and take over the country. So he issued a command to all his people, take every newborn Hebrew boy and throw him into the Nile River, but let the girls live. Yikes. So every Hebrew little boy would be thrown into the river and thus killed. That's sad. That's a mean guy, isn't it? That's not a nice man. But that's what the king did, because he was so scared because they were getting so many Israelites that they would come and take over and hurt him. Well, during that time, a woman, an Israelite Hebrew woman, had a baby boy. A baby. Did you make a face? Did you make a face? Oh, how about that one? That's a pretty good one. That's pretty good. Well, when she saw what a fine, handsome baby. Oop, I said it again. Baby. Oh, how about that face? Well, when she saw what a fine, handsome guy he was, she hid him for 3 months so that they would not find him and throw him into the river. They just hid him for 3 months. But it's kind of hard to hide a little guy, isn't it? Kind of hot. Yeah, they cry. They make noises. They giggle. You never do that, do you? But yeah, but as that baby, your big face. Ooh, how about that one? Well, as this little guy got older, she couldn't hide him any longer. So what she did is she made a basket of tall grass and covered it all over with tar to make it watertight so that it could not sink. It floated pretty good, even in the river. But then she put the baby. That was a pretty funny face. How about that one? Woo, that one's scary almost, right? But so she put him in the basket and hid it in the tall grass at the edge of the river. Well, the babies. Ooh, did you make a face? How about that one? Well, his sister stood some distance away on the edge of the river, hiding in what's called the reeds, or that's real high grass. And she was standing at a distance to watch and see what would happen to him to make sure that he was okay. Well, a little later, the king's daughter, that's a princess, came down to the river to bathe. And suddenly, she noticed the basket in the tall grass. And the princess looked in the basket and saw a baby. How about that face? Yep, she saw it. And he was crying. And she felt sorry for him. Who doesn't feel sorry, right? For a young one that's just crying like that. Poor little thing, right? Well, this was one of the Hebrew babies. I said it. Did you make a face? Ooh, look at that one. Look at that one. Yeah. 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 So she felt sorry for him. And she's, and so the sister asked the princess, you know, should I go ask a Hebrew woman to nurse the baby? you make a face? Ooh, look at that one. So again, she asked her to, can I go ask a Hebrew woman to nurse him for you? And the princess said, please do. She is. And so the girl went and brought the baby. Ooh, look at that one. But she went, she brought that little boy's own mother. Wow, that's wild, isn't it? The real mother. And the princess told the prince, the princess told the woman, take this baby. How's that picture? Yeah, take this little boy and nurse him for me, and I will pay you. So the mother took him home. He got to be with his own mother anyway. Isn't that neat? But later, when the child was old enough, the mother took the boy and gave him to the king's daughter, who adopted him as her own son. The king's daughter said to herself, I pulled him out of the water, so I will name him Moses, which means I pulled him out of the water. I mean, what an amazing story here of two mothers who loved their child and God's protection and care for them. God, Moses grew to be one of the greatest leaders of the people of Israel, one of the greatest they ever had known. And it all started with a little baby. Oh, look at that one. Look at that one. Look at that one. And it all started with that little boy in that basket that was hidden in the tall bushes down by the river. Down by the river. What was in that little basket? Oh, a baby! That one's not scary, but it's still kind of silly, isn't it? Yeah, it's still kind of silly, isn't it? Well, let's do this. Let's pray together and ask God to protect us too. Let's pray. Dear God, just as the mother of Moses watched over her son and protected him, you love and care for your children. We thank you for loving us. We thank you for your love and protection for even us, because we too are your children. And we thank you again. And we pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Well, wasn't that a fun lesson? Sure was. And you guys made some pretty funny faces. I think they were better than those pictures I showed you. I think they were. I think, and you know who you are that had the funny ones. Yeah. Well, make sure that next week, you do come back, because we're going to talk about Moses again, but now Moses is going to be a man, and he's going to be kind of a shepherd out working, and he's going to see an amazing sight up on the mountain. It is called the burning bush, and we're going to learn all about that next week. So make sure that you ask Mom and Dad if it's okay if you subscribe to this channel so you don't miss it. Okay, make sure you ask them, though, and make sure you invite your friends to come over and watch it with you so that you can see it together, because we're going to have a good time then, too. Well, everybody up on your feet, everybody on your feet, and we are going to march around and sing that song that we always sing as we leave, and that's about the B-I-B-L-E, the Bible. That's the book for me. So get ready to sing. If you want to make baby faces while you sing, that's okay too. But here we go. Know that we love you, and we will see you next week. God bless. Here. Here we go. Get ready. One, two, three, march!